Hey everyone, and welcome to our first episode of In the Lab. My name is Shen.
And my name is Haley. We're Meta employees reporting live in studio here today. Welcome to this new series on the Meta community, where we bring experts across Meta here to speak directly to you, address hot topics, answer your questions, and give you sneak peeks on what's coming up next. The first episode will be to address issues impacting Meta Quest PC users.
There's been a ton of chatter in the Meta Quest community, from stability to connectivity issues down to visual glitches. Yikes. We hear concerns, and as Haley just mentioned, we want to address them. So today, let's tackle them head on. Before we do, be sure to stay tuned until the end to hear about a new feature we're launching. You don't want to miss this.
Joining us today to help answer your questions is our quality assurance engineering lead, Abdallah Hilali, and Link product manager, Bharat Jayukumar. Welcome.
Welcome.
Happy to be here.
Yeah, thanks for having us. So, you know, we've been hearing your concerns on all the online forums about Link. And, you know, we're working really hard to make sure we fix all those issues pretty quickly and also improve the performance and the stability of Link. And, you know, we're really trying to improve Link even more. So, you know, definitely do stay tuned till the end. And we have a new feature that we will be talking about.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Bharat. I'm excited to hear about this new upcoming feature. So let's focus on Link setup and best practices. So I've personally experienced setting up both on Quest and Link, and they're two very different experiences. What are your best practices for setting up Link, whether it's on PC, using USB, using Air Link? And how do we set it up in a way where we have the best gaming experience or amazing performance?
Yeah, that's a great question, Shen. And you bring up a really good point. Like, setting up the headset and setting up Link is quite different. One's just the headset, the other one is the headset and the PC. So you want to make sure that you have the optimal experience overall when you're setting up the headset and the PC together. Two separate systems, and they're two separate systems working together, talking together to give you that Link experience. Now, I've kind of divided it up into four different categories. First and foremost, the PC. When setting up the PC, it's really important that you have a supported CPU and GPU. A CPU that we highly recommend is Intel Core i7 or better. From the GPU side, we highly recommend that you use the NVIDIA 20 series or AMD 5 series or above. Now, regarding USB Link, it's super important that you have a data cable and not a charging cable.
So I can't use my iPhone cable to connect my headset to my PC?
I mean, you can use it, but unfortunately, it's not going to be the best experience.
That's probably why.
It's a bad experience.
It's a bad experience. Yeah, Bharat has some some experience doing that, yeah, to be honest. So that's why we recommend our Meta Quest data cable that you can find at our Meta Quest store. It's because it's data transferring from the PC to the headset. And so you want to ensure the best data transfer between PC and headset, and with a charging cable that doesn't allow for that. For Air Link, it's super important that you use a 5G router.
And why is that?
Because with a 2.4 gigahertz router, you won't really have the most optimal experience. With 5G, it's been tested and it works very well.
And what are your recommendations to make sure that, you know, I would have the best connection? What are some things I could do? Are there any
That's a great question. For both, if you're using USB Link or Air Link, a common theme is to make sure that your PC is directly connected with Ethernet. That way, you have the direct connection, your internet's not really an excuse for why you're not having the best experience with Link. One more thing though, it's really important that you have the most up-to-date drivers, whether you're using your NVIDIA GPU or your AMD GPU. You can always check by downloading the driver software, depending on for the respective GPUs, and checking to see whether or not they've been up to date on a regular basis.
Super insightful. Thank you for that, Abdallah. I gotta ask, what is your go-to electronics store to buy all of this gear?
My go-to electronics store has to be the Meta store.
Great answer. Yeah.
Of course. So Abdallah, you've talked about the optimal setup experience. Now, so other feedback we've received from customers is that sometimes things have stopped working. So the steps that they've used before no longer work for them. I've worked in customer support for a couple of years, so I usually just recommend, you know, to turn things on and off. It usually works. But what would you recommend to customers that this is happening to?
You know, Haley, you're not wrong. Turning it off and turning it back on again sometimes is really the answer.
Does the trick.
It's been tested and it's been tried. But let me give a few troubleshooting steps that might help some users. I have some simple examples and I have some complicated ones. Which ones would you?
Let's go simple.
Okay, let's start off with simple. So first and foremost, if you ever experience any issues when trying to find your headset on your PC, the first go-to that you could do is going into the system settings and toggling on and off the link toggle that's within system settings on the headset itself. Next, if that doesn't work, what you can do is you can go onto the PC application. In the PC application, we have a beta restart section where you can beta restart the PC application. Kind of resets the services, turning it off, turning it back on again, same thing. If that doesn't work, if you're having experiences with USB link, maybe it's worth unplugging and replugging. That sometimes helps fix a lot of issues. And if all that doesn't work, maybe powering on, powering off the PC or headset, depending on where you're having your issues.
Okay. So I'm seeing a theme here.
Yeah.
Power on, power off.
So to summarize, it would be having the correct setup, and then if it's not working, turning on and off the hardware and the software of both devices. So software of the Quest headset, system settings, the Quest headset, the PC computer, and then also the PC app, and then of course the cable. If you're using it, just unplugging and plugging it back in.
Exactly. I told you it was simple. So.
Okay, so the more advanced steps.
So yeah, the more advanced steps are a little bit more complicated, but here are a few. Firstly, what you could do is you could check out your firewall, make sure that your Wi-Fi is allowing for public networks so that you could see your Meta Quest device on your local network. And also check to see your antivirus software. Make sure that it's not blocking that Meta Quest link connection. If that doesn't work, what you could do is you could also go into our Oculus Diagnostics folder. And within the Oculus Diagnostics folder, what you could do is you could repair the Meta Quest Link PC app. That basically resets all the services, reinstalls the application, and allows for a clean slate connection. Finally, if that doesn't work, the last thing that you could do is go into Task Manager and end the OVR service process. Again, kind of is the last resort, but it really resets everything.
So, Abdal, the other day I was playing a game and it was glitching. It was stuttering. It was the worst experience.
Oh, no.
I'm sure you've experienced this before.
Yes. I mean, I have, but I'm sorry. I'm sorry that you're experiencing that.
I know. That hurts.
Because it was pretty frustrating, and we found that our community, it's been a top issue for our customers experiencing just performance issues. So how do they encounter those issues in the first place? And what are your recommendations to fix it?
No, Shan, that's a great question. And I'm sorry that you had that experience, but I'm gonna give you a few tips and tricks that you could use in order for you to have a stable experience without any glitching, without any performance issues. First and foremost, what you need to make sure of is that your drivers are up to date. So depending on, again, just like we discussed, from the best setup practices, you want to make sure that your drivers, from whether it be AMD or NVIDIA, are updated to the latest version.
I'm guilty of not doing that. So yeah, I got to make sure I remember to make sure to update my drivers.
You got to make sure. Next up, if you're using Air Link, it's really important that you directly connect your PC to your router. In doing so, you will have better network connection. And especially if you're playing an online game, it'll make sure that your experience is much more stable.
You know, in the age of Wi-Fi, I forgot about Ethernet cords and the power of Ethernet cords. So
yeah, it's super important. Again, it really helps with a more stable experience.
Yep.
And lastly, if you're using USB link, again, we talked a little bit about the data cable. Super important that you have the data cable connected. Yeah. And that will result in better overall performance as opposed to having a charging cable.
Yeah, like my iPhone charging cable.
Yeah. Yeah.
What about like if I have a bunch of browser tabs open, is that going to affect the performance?
That's a great question. Yeah, if you have a lot of browser tabs, and honestly, for me, I have almost 50 at any given moment. Sometimes I have to remember to close out my tabs and and start fresh so that I could have a good overall link experience. That's something that I would highly recommend. Again, there's a reason why we recommend having a higher level CPU in order for you to be able to play Link in those VR games. So close out those tabs.
So I can't leave all my cheat codes open in 50 browser tabs.
You can, but as long as they're not 50 tabs.
Yeah. I gotta ask you, Adala, and thank you for that. What is your favorite VR PC game?
Yeah, my favorite PC game, I mean, I love to play a lot of them. But right now, I like Beat Saber and Asgard's Wrath.
Oh, Beat Saber, it's also one of my favorites.
Same, yeah. Maybe we could have a tournament later.
Yeah, like we have a challenge after this.
Yeah.
Bring it on. Yeah. And now let's talk about Air Link. So this would be the link that allows you to connect wirelessly without the cable, the data cable. Some users are reporting seeing the pairing code only in their headset and not on their PC app. What do you recommend that they do in this instance?
We talked a little bit about setup and how important it is to have the right setup. We also talked a little bit about how complicated Link could be because you have the PC aspect and you have the headset, right? Sometimes if you leave it for a long time, it really helps for you to do a kind of like a reset so that you can make sure that you don't experience any issues. When debugging Air Link pairing issues, one way that we recommend to debug is to go into settings and toggling on off Link in the Meta Quest headset system settings. Additionally, depending on where you're experiencing the issue, we highly recommend that you power on or power off your headset or your PC.
Okay, so it's going right back to those basic troubleshooting steps first, and that'll likely solve
exactly,
the issue.
Exactly. And with that, you'd be able to see your pairing code and you'd be able to use Air Link.
So we live in this era of always having to update your software. I'm guilty of not always doing that. But we've seen some user frustration around software updates. Software updates where they can't roll back to previous firmware. So why, from a business or technical standpoint, would Meta restrict that for users?
Yeah, that's a great question. I mean, first and foremost, before anything, it's really important that we tell our users that we hear you. We understand if you ever experience any issues, we see it, and we want to make sure to push out fixes as fast as possible. So totally understand any frustration that comes with that. Just be patient. We got you. In regards to why we don't downgrade software, well, our software updates come with a few things. Firstly, new features. So we want you to try out those new features that come out.
These include experimental features?
These include also experimental features, absolutely. Also, we have bug fixes that we had on the previous version of the software. We had some issues. We fixed those issues on the latest version. And finally, if a user really does want to go between different software versions, what they can do is they could simply opt into PTC. PTC, or better known as our public test channels, they have the latest versions of software where they can upgrade forward to the plus one release. Or if they want to, they can always downgrade by going backwards. So that's one way that they could also be able to upgrade and downgrade their software. And again, we highly recommend though for users to be on the latest, on whatever latest version on both the headset and the PC side. They both communicate together and it's really important that they're both on the same page so that they can have the optimal experience.
And just for folks that don't know what PTC is, do you mind?
So again, PTC is the public test channel. So it's usually like, think of it as like a beta channel per se, right? So it has like the latest features. It's not really well oiled per se, but it's the latest and greatest. You guys test it out for us and then we get your feedback and we implement it before the next release.
Thank you so much, Abdallah, for your insights. I feel really confident that we were able to give our users a good checklist, like in a structured way of things that they can do to troubleshoot their experience.
Absolutely.
So thanks for joining us.
No, thank you. Really appreciate it.
And Bharat, I'm excited to hear about the new feature.
Let's hear about it.
Yeah, so this is a really great new feature because people have been asking for this for a while.
Yeah.
So you can launch your PCVR applications now from the Quest library without having to go into the Dash interface, which is the one you have to go into that to launch any PCVR application. So now you can launch it directly from your Quest library. When you click on it, it'll prompt you to connect link if you haven't connected already, and then boom, you'll just be right in it. This is something that we have started to roll out to people. So, you know, if you don't have it right now, that's okay. It will be coming to you pretty quickly. So, yeah, so that's something we're really excited about. Just makes the experience easy for people.
Yeah, it's like a shortcut.
Exactly. It's like a shortcut. Yeah.
That wraps up our deep dive. Thanks so much again, Abdallah, Bharat, for joining us.
Oh, thanks for having us.
This is really timely for many Quest Link community users today. We really appreciate you coming here to recognize the feedback that we're getting on the community. And this is exactly the culture we're looking to establish by having this web series, having experts join to address feedback directly and inform customers of all the work we're doing to improve their experience. Your expertise helps put these complex topics into perspective.
And yeah, this was super helpful. I've learned some new troubleshooting tips and tricks today. So thank you again. And we hope this helps our awesome Meta community members solve issues they're experiencing with Link. Let us know if this episode helped, and be sure to subscribe to the Meta Store Support YouTube channel to find more troubleshooting videos. Please share your feedback and ideas for future episodes.
Until then,
see you next time
in the lab. In the lab.